Hi guys, Tiffany Arielle here, and we are back with another video in our Learn to Code series. So today we are doing part 3, which is the last part of that assignment that we've been doing for the past 2 videos. So part 3 is Ancient Game of Nimm. Nimm is an ancient game of strategy that is named after the old German word for take. It is also called Tiouk Tiouk in West Africa, and I'm not even gonna say this, in China. Players alternate taking stones until there are 0 left. The game of Nimm goes as follows. The game starts with a pile of 20 stones between the players. The 2 players alternate turns. On a given turn, a player may take either 1 or 2 stones from the center pile. The 2 players continue until the center pile has run out of stones. The last player to take a stone loses. Okay, cool. Write a program to play Nimm, and says they've broken it down into smaller milestones. Okay, and here they've mentioned the breakdown of the milestones, which I'm not going to go over right now because I have the notes for those different milestones inside the Python file itself. So we'll just skip over this for now. All right, we are in our Python file now. So we have milestone 1 first, which says start with 20 stones, repeat the process of removing stones and printing out how many stones are left until there are 0. Don't worry about whose turn it is. Don't worry about making sure only 1 or 2 stones are removed. Use the method input message, which we've been using this whole time, which prints message and waits for the user to enter an input. Make sure to convert the input into an int. Okay, so we're gonna use a constant, right? So we start with 20 stones. And I think that's the only thing we need a constant for right now. So it's saying, what are we supposed to do? I'm just supposed to print how many are left and ask how many they want to remove. Okay, so I'm going to do this. So we have print. There. Actually, let me change something. So we need to remove stones. And we need to keep track of how many we have left, right? So that means we need another variable called remaining. I'm gonna initialize remaining to be start because obviously at the very beginning we haven't taken any away, so we have the same. But we're gonna be subtracting from remaining each time. So again, we don't know how many iterations we have, so we have a while loop. While remaining is greater than 0 because, yeah, we're just trying to take away all the stones. Then we print, right? There are, again, we're concatenating and converting remaining into a string, stones left, period. Okay, then we have input, would you like to take 1 or 2 stones, ? I think that might work. I'll call it take. Oh, and they said we have to convert it to an int, so we're gonna make sure we do that as well. So then after we've taken 1 or 2 stones, we need to remaining, we need to subtract that from how many are remaining. So let's see if this works. So we run, oh, sorry, 1 second. I need to change this to run milestone 1 function and not milestone 3 because why is this gray? I don't know. Is it here? Oh. Function name should be low, whatever. I don't care about that. Okay. Nimm. Okay, it's saying I'm going to put 10. Okay, it said there's 10 left. Okay, let's put 8. Okay, there's 2 left. Okay, I take 2. Okay, cool, and it stopped. Okay, cool, so this seems to work. Okay, so let's move on to milestone 2. It says create a variable type int to keep track of whose turn it is, and there are 2 players. Tell the user whose turn it is, and then change the player number. Okay, so we're gonna copy what we already did because we're not trying to like do this to work together. And now we're gonna modify it. So we need a variable type int, so we'll say turn. So we're gonna assume that player 1 is gonna go first, so I'll just set it to 1. Tell the user whose turn it is. Okay, so here I'm telling the user whose turn it is, so I'm just gonna do player And I'm gonna do turn think that should work. Let me just check if my printing is working properly before I worry about changing the turns, because I don't know. Change that to milestone 2. And let's just see. Player 1. Okay, yeah, this printing looks fine. There are 20 stones left. Players don't. There are 20 stones left. Player 1, would you like to take 1 or 2 stones? Okay, cool. So that's fine. So now, I think this is fine. I think the only thing I still need to do is I need to keep track of whose turn it is. So that means I need to switch the turn. So if turn is 1, I need to set turn equals to 2. Otherwise, I'll set turn equals 1. That might work. Yeah, that might work. Okay, let's try. Okay, 1 or 2 stones. Okay, I'll do 5. Okay, give me 15. That's correct. Okay, it's asking me player 2, so that's good. I'll do 7. Okay, 8. Okay, it went back to player 1, so that's good. I'll just pick 8 and just make this end. Okay, so that seems to work fine. Okay, so what is milestone 3? Make sure that each turn only 1 or 2 stones are removed. Okay. So let's copy this again, because we're not about to start from scratch. Okay, so it's saying take is this. It gave me a pattern. Let me go look and see, because I guess I didn't copy. Oh, here. So it's saying while input is invalid, input equals blah, blah, blah. Okay, so let me copy this. So this is my input. So I think that should be here. So now how, let me change this to take so that my variables are matching. So how do I know if it's invalid? So it's saying while input is invalid. So what would make my input invalid? If it's not 1 or 2. So I know that it's an int, right? So I know that it cannot be between 1 and 2. So what I'm gonna say is while take is less than 1 or it's greater than 2. Because if it's less than 1, that means it's either 0 or a negative number, which is not what I want. If it's more than 2, that means it's obviously more than 2. I know that it's impossible for the number to be between 1 and 2 because it's an int. Now, if these were floats, then I might have to worry about somebody typing 1.5 or something. But we're not doing floats, so we don't have that problem. So I think this might work. So let's run milestone 3. Player 1, would you like to take 1 or 2 stones? Let's type 8. Okay, it's telling me please enter 1 or 2. Okay, let's type 4. Still telling me to please enter 1 or 2. Let's type 0. Still telling me that. I type 2. 18 stones left. 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 1. What happens if I do 2? Okay, now it ended. Okay, so what else am I supposed to do? Okay, it says, as a final touch, announce the winner after the game is over. Okay, so they said that, what did they say the winner was? They said the last player to take a stone loses. So basically what that means is after I take my turn, if I took the last stone, that means I lost, which means the person whose turn would be next is the winner. So, because we're already flipping the turn here, all I have to do is just, like, print player. Oops. I think this should work. Player wins. Yeah. Oh, I need a space. But yeah, it seems to work. Player 2 took the last stone, so player 1 wins. Okay, so yeah, I think this is working. So, that is it for today. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with all your friends. And please don't forget to come back for more videos in the Learn to Code series. Bye!